Well, I shared with you that I've been ministering in deliverance for 35 years. I preached thousands of messages in the area of deliverance, and I'm still discovering new truths concerning deliverance in the scripture. I was on another platform recently, and the people of that platform, there's a pastor actually from the United Kingdom, Pastor Shola. He and many of his members began to share this scripture concerning breaking free. Now, I never heard this before. I've read the verse before, but somehow I never really saw the revelation from this verse. It is the verse that talks about, or the chapter rather, chapter 27 of Genesis, Genesis 27. Remember where Jacob deceives Isaac, deceives Isaac into giving him the blessing. And then Esau comes and Isaac recognizes that I've been deceived and tricked by your brother. He has received the blessing. And so Esau says, is there any blessing left for me? In other words, the blessing meant that Jacob would be an authority over Esau. The blessing put Jacob in a position of dominion. And so Esau says, Father, do you have anything for me? And the Lord gives him a word. Thank you, Roslyn. The Lord gives him a word that I think is very instructive concerning breaking free. And I want to read this verse to you. It says this in Genesis 27 and verse number 40. You can write it down. Look at it later. Don't forget, by the way, I'm still teaching out of my book, Activate Heaven. This book is the newest book, How to Use the Power of Your Voice to win your battles and walk in favor. Activate Heaven. You can get copies of it at Amazon.com, ChristianBooks.com, or if you want a signed copy, you can get it from JohnEckhardt.Global. This book will give a revelation concerning the power of your voice, the power of your voice, how to release your voice. The heavens declare the glory of God. There is a declaration that comes from the heavens, and we're sitting in heavenly places, and the kingdom inside of us is a heavenly kingdom. So when we speak and release our voice, it's as if heaven is speaking. And when heaven speaks and declares, glorious things begin to manifest. So get your copy today. It's called Activate Heaven. Again, you can get it at Amazon.com, ChristianBooks.com, or signed copies at JohnEckhardt.Global. Okay, let me read the verse for you, Genesis 27 and 40. It says, this is Isaac speaking to Esau. Esau gets a word. Well, often when we think about Esau, we think that because he was fleshly, sold his birthright, there's nothing good about Esau. But God gives Esau a word, a prophetic word. It says this, and by thy sword thou shalt live, and thou shalt serve thy brother. And it shall come to pass when thou shalt have the dominion that thou shalt break his yoke from off thy neck. Notice the word is, you're going to be under the dominion of your brother. You're going to serve him. But there's coming a time when you have the dominion, you'll break his yoke from off thy neck. You'll break his yoke from off thy neck. So it's a tremendous verse about someone. Okay, thank you so much, Stafford. God bless you, sir. Thank you so much for your seed into PayPal. It's a picture about someone having a yoke on their neck, which is a picture of bondage, submission, and yet they break free. And the scripture says, when you have the dominion. Now, when I looked that word dominion up in the Hebrew, it literally means to be restless. And I want to read some other translations of this verse because they kind of amplify the verse. The CEB translation says, you will live by your sword. You will serve your brother. But when you grow restless, you will tear away his harness from your neck. When you grow restless. And then the CEV version says this, you will live by the power of your sword and be your brother's slave. But when you decide to be free, you will break loose. I like that because sometimes people, deliverance from bondage comes when you make a decision to break free. when you grow tired, when you grow weary, when you grow restless, when you say enough is enough, this is what God is saying to Esau. You're going to be under the dominion of Jacob, but there's coming a time when you're going to decide to be free. You're going to grow restless. You're going to make a decision and you're going to break loose. Deliverance always usually begins when people become tired and restless of their bondage. They say enough is enough. I'm going to break free from that. You know, you can't force people to be delivered. They have to get to a place where they're so exasperated. They're so frustrated. They're so tired of the bondage. They're so tired of being having a yoke on their neck until they become restless. They become a person that says, no, I'm going to break free. The Easy Read version says this: you will have to fight to live, and you will be a slave to your brother. But when you fight to be free, you will break away from his control. When you fight to be free, you will break away from his control. The EXB version says, you will live by using your sword. This is the word to Esau, who would be a slave to his brother. But it's coming a time he's going to break that yoke and break free. You will live by using your sword, and you will be a slave to serve your brother. But when you struggle or become restless, you will break free from him, his yoke from your neck. And so again, the implication is, Esau, you're going to be under this dominion. There's going to be a yoke on your neck for a period of time, but there's coming a time when you become restless, when you make a decision, when you fight, when you struggle, when you say enough is enough, you're going to break free. I've seen people break free out of bad relationships, bad situations, their bad financial situations. When they make a decision, enough is enough. I'm not going to sit here and remain in bondage. I'm not going to sit here and let this yoke remain on my neck. I'm restless. I'm going to struggle. I'm going to fight. I'm going to make a decision. I'm going to break out of this slavery. That is a major turning point when it comes to breaking free. So that's why I'm calling this message Breaking Free. The Good News Translation says it this way: you will live by your sword, but be your brother's slave. Yet when you rebel, you will break away from his control. When you rebel against this, when you say, no, I'm not doing this, you have to rebel against your bondages. You have to fight and get restless when it comes to your bondage. You have to say, enough is enough. I am not going to be in this bondage. I'm going to break free. I'm going to break the yoke. I'm going to break the chains. So many times deliverance comes when you're tired, when you say enough is enough. That's when the decision comes, I'm going to be free. And then the LEB translation says, but by your sword you shall live, and you shall serve your brother. But it shall be that when free yourself, you shall tear off his yoke from your neck. So there is a time when you can free yourself. One verse I've written on is a verse in the book of Isaiah, which says, "Loose thyself from the bands of your neck." I call it self-deliverance. I've written a book, it may not even be in print anymore, called Loose Thyself, where there were prayers where people would actually loose themselves. Thank you, Lydia. God bless you. Thank you. God bless you. Okay, so there are times in your life when you need to free yourself. If it's a bad relationship, if you're in an abusive relationship, if you're under a controlling leader, a controlling pastor in a controlling church. On another platform, I do something on another platform, and we had a subject called Identifying Controlling Leaders. And you should see the horror stories of people who come out of controlling churches and controlling ministries and controlling leaders. But many of them make a decision to break free. They leave. Sometimes the leader curses them. You got to learn how to break those curses. You got to learn how to loose yourself. You cannot sit there and be a doormat. You cannot sit there and remain in bondage. You got to get so tired of it and so tired and so restless until you begin to fight against it. You begin to rebel against it. And many of them are breaking free. When they heard the teaching, they begin to break free and come out of these controlling relationships and dominating relationships. abusive relationships, things that have you bound, whether it's poverty, lack, addiction, perversion. You've got to rebel against it. You've got to get like Esau. I've been a servant too long. I've been a slave to Jacob too long. I'm going to break free. I'm going to make a decision. I'm going to take this yoke off. I'm going to tear this yoke off my neck. There is something about restlessness. When people become restless, when groups of people become restless, they can be in bondage for years. But when they make a decision that enough is enough and they become restless, that is one of the first steps to breaking free from your taskmaster, from your slave owner, from the powers of darkness so that you can be set free. And so that's the key to breaking free. There are people that they're not restless enough. They're not angry enough. They're not tired enough of their bondage. They tolerate it. They put up with it. They don't struggle. They don't fight. They don't rebel against it. And if you don't do something, you will remain in bondage. You've got to make a decision. You've got to set yourself free. Now we can pray for you and we can cast devils out and we can minister deliverance. But until you get to the place to get up and walk out of a situation, walk out. I've learned this about demons. Demons cannot hold you against your will. When you begin to exercise your will and you begin to exercise your authority, the scripture says in the King James, when you shall have the dominion, when you have the authority. Other translation says when you're restless, but in the King James, it says when you have the dominion, when you have the authority, when you rise up and take authority, when you rise up and take your place, when you begin to exercise your will, your power, your authority, you will break free from this thing. You will tear this yoke from off of your neck and you will liberate yourself. So that's a word of encouragement to many of you. Don't be a doormat. Don't sit there and just let the enemy bind you and be afraid to do anything. No, you rebel against it. You say, I'm rebelling against this bondage. I'm coming against this yoke. It will not control my life. I'm going to make a decision to fight. I'm going to struggle. I'm going to break out of this thing. When you make that kind of decision, you're on your way to breaking free. And again, if you're just coming on, please share the broadcast. Please share the broadcast. Someone needs to hear this broadcast. This broadcast is going around the world. Someone needs to hear this verse of scripture. Go to it, read it. I shared it with you. Again, it's Genesis 27 and 40. And by thy sword shalt thou live and shall serve thy brother. And it shall come to pass when thou shalt have the dominion, when you begin to use your authority, when you begin to use your power, when you become restless, then thou shalt break his yoke from off thy neck. Thank God there is breaking free from yokes and bondages when you make a decision and you rise up and begin to exercise your authority and exercise your power. So, Father, I pray for everyone that is watching. I pray that they would operate in dominion, power, authority, that they would rebel against any bondage, anything in their life that's holding them captive, that they'll make a decision to be free, that they'll fight against it, that they'll come out, they'll tear the yoke from off their neck. They'll be free, Lord, to move in a new place of liberty, into a new place of freedom, whether it's financial, whether it's relationships, whether it's a church, a ministry, whatever it is, you are breaking free. I prophesy that many of you are going to rise up in this year and this season, and this will be your year to struggle and to break out and to break through and to fight against and to exercise dominion. And you'll be like Esau when he broke free from Jacob. You'll be like Esau when he tore the yoke from off of his neck and he became free. You'll be like Esau that had the word of the Lord from his father Isaac, that son, you're going to be a servant, a slave for a period of time. There's coming a time when you will become restless and you're going to struggle, fight, and take dominion, and you're going to break free. And so, Father, I thank you, Lord, that those who are restless, those who are tired, those who have said enough is enough, this is the beginning of their season of breakthrough. And I decree breakthroughs and breakouts. I decree breakthroughs for your life, your finances, your relationships, relationships, that you'll not be subject or slave to any man, any situation, but I prophesy and decree that you're breaking through. You're breaking through because you've come to a place where enough is enough. I'm tired. I'm restless. I can't take it anymore. I will not take it anymore. I'm going to loose myself. I'm going to free myself. I'm going to break out of this, whatever it takes. I'm going to rip this yoke from off my neck, and I decree liberty and freedom to many of you that are watching today. This broadcast is a prophetic word to you that you're coming into a season of liberation. You're coming into a season of freedom. But the Lord said, out of the season of frustration, out of the season of restlessness, out of the season of tiredness, you're going to break out. And what would be your enemy, the frustration, what would hold you back is going to be the catalyst for you breaking forth and moving forth, says the Lord. What used to hold you in bondage will hold you in bondage no more. For the Lord says, you've come to the tipping point. You've come to the place where you have nothing to lose. And you say, even as Esther said, if I perish, I perish. And she came into the presence of the king, and deliverance came to her people. There's coming a time now, in a season now, of desperation, of people saying enough is enough. And the Lord said, now get ready to move into a new season of breakthrough, freedom, and liberation. Breakthrough, freedom, and liberation. Breakthrough, freedom, and liberation. And I hear the Lord said that financial freedom is coming to many of you, for you're saying, I'm tired of poverty. I'm tired of lack. I'm going to break out of this. This will not hold me back. I'm going to do business. I'm going to do the marketplace. I'm going to rise up. I'm going to break through. I'm going to believe God. I'm going to shake this yoke of poverty and this yoke of lack off of my life. I'm going to move into a wealthy place. And so the Lord said, as you rise up, even as Esau did, and shake yourself free and loose yourself, financial restrictions and financial limitations are coming off of your life. And it's a new season of liberty. It's a new season of freedom. It's a new season of breakthrough for your life, says the Lord. So receive this word today, for I send my word to heal you and to deliver you out of every destruction, bondage, yoke, and limitation that would hold you back. You'll be a slave no more. You'll be a slave no more. You'll be a slave no more. You'll be in bondage no more. You'll free yourself. You'll loose the bands from your neck. You'll loose yourself. You'll come out of this situation and you'll leave the past behind and you'll move into a new day of freedom, liberation, and breakthrough. Father, I decree it, I prophesy it, and I release it today in Jesus' name. Amen, amen, amen. Well, thank you so much for sharing. If you haven't shared, you came on late, please share the broadcast. If you came on late, go back and watch the broadcast from the beginning. If you want to sow a seed, you can do so through the stars here on Facebook Live. Again, thank you, Sabrina, for sowing on PayPal. You can go to Cash App at JE Global or PayPal at paypal.me/ApostleJE, the number one. Now, I've been ministering on this platform for 10 years. I've been doing lives, and it wasn't until last year that I began to challenge people to sow. So I put 9 years of work and labor and ministering. And if you never sow anything, you don't have to pay for anything. It's up to you. If the Lord touches your heart, do so. If you want to be a blessing, I believe there's a release of favor that will come on your life when you sow into those who minister to you, feed you, labor in the word. I believe that you'll receive a great breakthrough. He that receives a prophet in the name of a prophet shall receive a prophet's reward. So